and then you're going to be doing a pattern sheet for your times threes. Okay? So if I want to find 3 times 5, I can skip count by 3 5 times. I like the way Ori got her fingers out. Let's all get our fingers out. Get ready to skip count by 3 5 times. You guys skip count. I'm going to write it here. 5 times. Do it until you get 5 fingers up. Ready? 3.
5, 6, 9, 12, 15.
And you stop right there. So 3 times 5 is 15. What did we do? We skip counted by 3 5 times. So 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. Okay. Let's see. Let's do 3 times 4. How many times will we have to skip count by 3, Freya? 4 times. Let's try that, boys and girls. 3, 6, 9, 12. There you go. 3 times 4 is 12. 3, 6, 9, 12. Okay. Now, what you also do, if you know that 3 times 5 is 15, let's say you're doing the pattern sheet, and 3 times 5 is 15 comes up, and the next one is 3 times 4. Well, guess what you can do? You can just take 15 and subtract 3 to get 12. So that's another strategy you can use, or you can just count, skip out 3, 6, 9, 12. Okay? I will tell you this, the pattern sheet you're doing today is just 3 times 1 through 3 times 5 over and over and over again. So you're going to be only doing the first 5 facts of 3 on the whole pattern sheet. There will be 60 problems, okay? 15 rows of 4. And so that is way more than I would expect you to get done in 2 minutes, isn't it? So what I'd like you to shoot for, I'd like you to shoot for to getting as close to 10 rows, because 10 times 4 would be 40. Yeah, so do your best to get 10 times 4. I don't really expect anybody to finish the sheet in 2 minutes, okay? Are you ready? I'm going to pass out the sheets, and you may, I'll tell you when to start. Yes, right. Oh, I got to pass out the pen. That's your application problem. We're going to do that afterwards. Okay? Holy moly.
Holy moly.
Please leave your page face down on your desk. Remember, if you want to see the pattern, you have to go across the rows. There's another time where knowing what rows are is really important. You don't need to put your name on this, because you're just going to be putting it right in your folder when you get done. It's not a time test. It's just a way for us to practice how fluent we are with our facts. Okay? So remember, you're going to go, if you want to see the pattern, you're going to go across the rows. Okay? So you may be skip counting up, or maybe you'll skip count backwards, yes.
Is it just threes?
It's just threes. It's just, let's practice it. 3 times 1 is?
3.
3 times 2 is? 6. 3 times 3 is?
5.
3 times 4 is?
12.
3 times 5 is?
15.
Those are the only 5 problems you're going to see on this over and over and over again. Oh, and say, wow, that's too easy almost, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, sorry. Exactly, you're right. If you're on your threes right now, it probably is going to be a little bit easier for you because you've been practicing them at home. All right, everybody ready? You will get 2 minutes. Get as many done as you can. Remember, go across the rows, and your goal is to try to get as close to 10 as you can. Some people might get more, okay? On your mark, get set, and begin. not a sprint, so you're not going to give me a fist pump and a yes. All right? We're going to just see how many people will be able to get to 10 rows. Okay? Remember, I'm reading the answers going across the rows. And I'll show you why we're doing that in just a moment. Let's go to the first row. Check your answers. 3, 6, 9, 12. Those go right in order, don't they? 3, 6, 9, 12. That's why that was supposed to go that way, because it would make sense. Next row. 15, 3, 6, 3. Next row, 9, 3, 12, 3. Next row, 15, 3, 6, 9. The next row, 6, 12, 6, 15. The next row, 6, 3, 6, 9. That sixth row, should I keep going? Okay, next row, 3, 9, 6, 9. Next row, 12, 9. 12, 3, 12, 6. Next row, 12, 9, 12, 15. Next row, 12, 15, 3, 15. God bless you. And that is 10 rows. How many people were able to get that? Awesome. Very good. So that's what you would be expected to do on a time test. You would be expected to do 40 in 2 minutes. Should I keep going? Raise your hand. Okay. Okay, the next row is 6, 15, 9, 15. The next row is 12, 6, 12, 9. The next row is 15, 9, 6, 12. And the last row is 9, 15, 6, 12. Okay? So just another way for us to practice our fluency and keep hammering away at those facts. You may put those in your green folder. And then look at your application problem, read it to yourself, and underline your notes. Okay? Yes. You're right, it was only 3 times 1 is 2. Raga, remember, you're supposed to be getting up your application problem packet and opening up to lesson 11 and underlining your notes. Read it together on the count of 1, 5, 3, 2, 1. Rosie puts two lemon slices in each cup of iced tea. She uses a total of 8 slices. How many cups of iced tea does Rosie make? Okay, what is one known that you think we should underline? Remember, boys and girls at home, you can pause the video at this point and do your own application problem and then compare it. Okay, 2 lemon slices in each cup of iced tea. So what are you picturing right now in your head? Raga. Yeah, a cup of iced tea with 2 lemons in it. Can all of you picture that? Okay, what else do we know? It's another no. Uh-oh. Slices. And what is our unknown? In other words, what is the problem asking us to figure out? Malia.
How many cups of iced tea does she make?
Okay, so you have to figure out how many cups of iced tea she makes. You know, she uses a total of 8 lemons, and there's 2 lemons in a cup. You can kind of picture that. That should help you with your drawing. And then you need to write a number sentence and a target sentence, as always with the rewriting process. Okay? Remember, use your knowns. Write your number sentence, and I'm going to let you go ahead and work on that, and then we'll put a solution under the Elmo and compare our work to one of our classmates. Okay. All right, boys and girls, so this is one of your classmates' solutions. For those of you at home, you can compare what you did to this person's work, all right? And we're going to award this person trophies for band-aids for what they can do better as you're comparing your work to theirs, okay? Remember, there's more than one way to represent a problem with pictures. So what is one trophy we could give this student, Ori? Yeah, that is what I gave her above and beyond for. So you can see she wrote her number sentence, and where? Why did she use 82? She used 8 because that was the total, and 2 was the 2 lemon slices in each cup. So she used her nouns, 8 divided by 2 equals 4. She even went so far as to label her 4 as the quotient or unknown factor. So when you do a division sentence, that's what you're looking for, okay? What else can we give this student a trophy for, Corbin? Okay, now she did 2 pictures. Now this array definitely represents a problem. And Corbin said these 2 circles represent 2 lemons. So 2, 4, 6, 8. She stopped when she got to 8. Here she used equal groups. So each circle represents a cup, and each circle has 2 lemons in it. So she also did 2, 4, 6, 8. I also like the way she counted 1, 2, 3, 4, which said how many cups she used. Okay? So she did a skip count, and then she counted how many groups she used. All right, so nice job on both those pictures and all your skip counting. Do you have another trophy you'd like to present to her, Lucas?
The target.
Okay, very good. You want to read that for us?
She has 4 cups of iced tea.
Yes, perfect. How many cups of iced tea does Rosie make? She has 4 cups of iced tea. Very nice. Can you think of any band-aids, anything she could do better? And remember, we don't comment on capitals or periods or spelling because that's ELA. And we're really about the meat of the problem, the read, draw, write process. Raga?
Next time, she could sit down.
Again, that's more of an ELA thing. I think it's quicker to just write she. Anybody else have a suggestion? Okay, how about this? Does anybody want to share with me, now that you're looking at this solution and comparing your work, does anybody have a misunderstanding that came out when we looked at this that you'd like to share with the class? Lucas, what was your misunderstanding? Okay, so you're saying you did 4 times 2 equals 8. Okay, and does that number sentence represent the picture, boys and girls? It does, you're right. But now I'm going to ask you, which one of these numbers in that number sentence is your unknown? 4, very good. So I'm okay with this. The only thing I would do is box it or circle it or underline it. And kudos go to Raghav because that's exactly what he did. He wrote 8 divided by 2 equals 4. He also wrote this number sentence, but he indicated which number was his unknown by underlining it. Does that make sense? Because when we look at this, we have to decide which thing were we looking for. Were we looking for the 4, the 2, or the 8? Would you all agree we were looking for the 4? Okay. Any more questions on this? Yes, Porter. Okay, that's right. Nice job, Val. And for those of you at home, we're going to do a little more skip counting. I'm going to pause the video for a minute, and then we're going to go back and do a little more skip counting before we finish our day. Started at 20, okay, 20, 18, 16, remember, we are going to go back and forth on some tricky transitions. So when we're skip counting, some of these might be tricky for us. Okay? Here we go, boys and girls. Ready? Skip count from 0 to 40. 0, 4,
8, 12, 16, 20,
24, 20, 24, 20, 24, 20, 24, 28, 32, 36, 40. So what was the tricky transition that we did there in that skip counting pattern, Ori?
24.
Yeah, 24 to 20. We went back and forth from that a couple times. Okay, we're going to do it again. This time we're going to practice another tricky transition. Okay, are you ready? Let's go. 0, 4, 4,
8, 12,
16, 20, 24, 28, 32, 28, 32, 28, 32, 28, 32, 36, 40. Very nice, boys and girls. Okay? And, boys and girls at home, do your skip counting and it will help you practice your facts. Have a great day.